Hey, Nephilim Free here. Did you know that evolutionism is not rational? It's not even logical. It makes no sense whatsoever. Evolutionists claim that random genetic mutations cause morphological changes to creatures. And this is how, this is the base mechanism for evolution. And that accruing random mutations in the genome of all the species of creatures in the world has caused them to change morphologically from one kind into a new kind. 70 years of random genetic mutation experimentation have been performed, and not one single instance of a permanent morphological change to a creature, to a species, has been observed. Deformities are weeded out in you know, the offspring. They disappear. There's no morphological change. No example of new structures arising in a creature because of random mutation, or existing features being transformed into ones with new biomechanical functions by mutation. See, evolutionists claim a lot of things about bones. They claim that bones arise from nothing. They claim that cartilage transforms into new bones. And they claim that existing bones split. Like, here's a bone in a bone process, and this bone then splits. And now a new bone comes off of that bone. They've claimed all those things about bones. There's no evidence that any of that's possible, much less that it's ever happened. See, evolutionism, it's not logical. Before time, space, energy, and matter existed, there was nothing. That's special creation. That's not evolution. All things have a cause. Science proves that all things, material, have a cause. But you can't have something, you can't have time, space, matter, or energy without all of them existing. So what existed that's material that could cause a Big Bang? Nothing. See? That's special creation. It's not evolution. Evolution contends that something that exists changes into something new. If time, space, matter, and energy didn't exist, what's their material then to cause the Big Bang? To cause the chemical elements to arise by fusion and whatnot? There's nothing that exists. There's no material cause. See, evolutionism refutes itself. It's a purely materialistic religion. But before the Big Bang, there was nothing material. So there's no material cause because evolutionists claim that all things have a material cause, and that everything is caused endlessly by one material cause causing another material cause causing another material cause. But before the Big Bang, there was no such thing as material. There was nothing material. So what caused it to come into being? Sure wasn't material, was it? Something supernatural, that is, outside of time, space, and matter, that exists on its own without time, space, energy, and matter. That's supernatural. See, even philosophy proves evolutionism doesn't make sense. Furthermore, there couldn't have been a Big Bang, because there's not enough matter in the universe for it to have exploded. They've proven that. So the evolutionists invent dark matter. That's scientific to them. To invent things like dark matter. Do you know that evolutionist astronomers actually claim that galaxies stay together because dark matter surrounds the galaxy, holds it together like some kind of magnetic shell that surrounds it? That doesn't make sense. Because if dark matter were attracted to visible matter, tangible matter, then it would not simply surround a galaxy and hold it in place, but it would infiltrate the galaxy and be everywhere. If that were so, it would cause massive problems with the galaxy. Galaxies could not exist. It would create gravity that would pull the galaxy every which way from Sunday and cause it to collapse. See, evolutionism doesn't make sense. You see, the galaxies, there's no reason, we have no mechanism for them to form in nature. They can't explain how they even came to be. On top of that, the outside of them is spinning in with along with the inside. Here's the inside, here's the outside. They spin together. But they look like a vortex, just like water in your drain. But they don't operate that way. There's no explanation for that. They can't be. There's no explanation in physics to allow a galaxy to exist, which is why evolutionists concoct dark matter and say, oh, dark matter solves it. See, the dark matter surrounds the galaxy and holds it in place. That's science. But just because you can point a laser beam into space and it bends doesn't mean dark matter exists. How do you know what's out there bending it? We don't know that. These light beams are bending billions and billions and billions of miles from the Earth. We don't know what's out there bending it. Doesn't it make sense to say dark matter's doing it? There's no evidence of dark matter. Not one. tiny bit of evidence that dark matter exists. And if dark matter did exist, it wouldn't collect itself around a galaxy. It would be drawn by the gravitational pull of that material to go inside the galaxy and fill it. It would be all over. In fact, it would head towards the center where the mass is greatest. Is that happening? Well, if it did, the galaxy itself wouldn't exist. So obviously, there's no dark matter ring surrounding a galaxy holding it together. And you know, atheism is not rational either. It's not. You look around the world, you go outside, step outside your back door, you got bugs flying around in the air, you got the wind, you've got the sky, you've got rainbows, you've got the grass, you've got bugs crawling around in the grass, there's ants and deer running across the field out there, and you look at all this and say, what God? What created this? It arose from nothing. It arose from nothing. Genetics discredits evolution all by itself. DNA is information which stores information storage medium which stores information in three dimensions with overlapping and embedded sequences which uses algorithms and linguistics law. But nature has no mechanism to produce information, algorithms, or linguistics. Nature can't be the producer of DNA. It's impossible. Evolution doesn't make sense. Do you know that Chinese is the oldest continually written language in the world, and that its origin as a written language started just about the time of the flood of Noah, according to the Bible? Yeah. And guess what? If you take the pictographic characters of the Chinese language for ship, and you break it down into its various components, guess what it says? 8 mouths, or persons, on a boat. Let me think. Let's see. Noah, his wife, their 3 sons. That's 5. Their 3 wives. That's 8. Wow. Evolutionists claim that a primordial goo is the origin of life, that random molecular interactions created the first life form. They organize themselves into stupefying complexity, interdependence, and beauty. You know what? To claim this, you know what they do? They envision this environment, this early Earth that has no oxygen. You know why? Because oxygen and water are acid to biological molecules. They make them break apart and fall apart. See, abiogenesis would be completely impossible in the environment of this Earth, because science has proven that the Earth had far much more oxygen content in the past than it does today. And that the Earth has been globally flooded, so abiogenesis would really be impossible, because the acidic properties of water and oxygen upon molecular biological molecules would decay those molecules trillions of times faster than any random genetic random molecular interaction could possibly assemble molecules into something of increasing complexity. It turned into this, you see, this ink pen, steel. And it got a cartridge inside instead of the lead. Cool. But then, that's what happened. Look, check this out. It turned into an X-Acto knife. It got rid of the cartridge inside, and the tip of the pen evolved into a blade. It evolved! They take creatures of similar homology, which have the same morphology, creatures within which are varieties within a particular kind, and they lay them next to each other and say, look, this one's evolving into that one. Oh, really? How come they don't do that with dogs? We've got dogs that have long hair, short hair, got some small dogs, got Chihuahuas, got Great Danes. They all have the same morphology, same body plan, same organs, same muscles, same tendons, same cartilage, all in the same location in their body plan. They have the same morphology, but they look dramatically different. But how come evolutionists don't say one is evolved from the other? Well, it's because we observe that dog breeds are a product of man, interbreeding, and a product of genetic variability and the loss of genetic information. So they don't claim that, see, because it's observed, testable, and repeatable. See, evolutionists don't like that. That's science. See, and evolutionists, evolutionism is not science, so it can't be that. Can't be observable, testable, and repeatable. So they dig up creatures that no longer exist. They're extinct. And they take 2 creatures, like 2 varieties of dogs. See, they would do that with dogs, but they know they can't, because dogs, we know that dogs were created by genetic variability and loss of genetic information by man breeding different dogs that have different, you know, looks to them, and creating various breeds. But so what the evolutionist does is they dig up 2 varieties, like dogs, of the same kind, and they place them next to each other and say, see, look, this one evolved into that one. How come they don't do that with dogs? It's because it's observable, testable, and repeatable science.